Today we're going back in time to look at how we replace some lamps that may no longer exist.
I told you you were going to be John Hammond and that was a raptor egg.
Well, it's not an egg, Gary, it's actually a lamp. It's the Osram HQL LED Pro Generation 4, manufactured by Ledvance.
Okay, so as we're at Generation 4, take me back one stage, what was Generation 3 like?
Okay, so here's our Generation 4, but Generation 3, if you've been looking at it, would have been looking at like those corn lamps that are often referred to. And there's a few disadvantages with corn lamps that we'll come on to, but where are we going to be using this? Well, say a lot of lamps, mercury vapour lamps, low-pressure sodium lamps, some of the high-pressure sodium lamps, as time goes on, they get difficult to get.
Right, okay, and we're thinking perhaps in areas like heritage areas, maybe, communal parking areas where the light fittings there are actually more elegant and beautiful. Is that what you're thinking?
Yeah, immediately people leap in, say, oh yeah, just replace it with a new LED floodlight or a new fixture, but problems in a lot of installations is this historic light fittings, yeah. And you're trying to match the existing look and feel, and that's where this comes in.
So we just simply go to the fitting itself, remove, say, the mercury vapour lamp, and just pop that one in, problem solved?
Yes, so this will work with conventional control gear.
Right, okay.
So you just, remove the existing lamp and retrofit it with a conventional control gear, or it will work with a direct-to-main supply if you want to get rid of the conventional control gear.
So there's nothing in the control gear, I'm going to remove the igniter, I know that's a common thing.
Yeah, you do have to remove igniters.
Right, okay, in order to fit.
Ballasts it will work with, but yeah, without it, take the igniter out.
So that's nice and simple, I like that. So shall we have a closer look at it and perhaps run through some of its features?
We'll look at some of the features.
Okay, so.
So here I've got the 29-watt version.
Right, okay, and what wattages does it come in?
So it's 15. Watts with 2,000 lumens, 22 watts at 3,000, and this 29-watt one at 4,000 lumens.
Okay, and normally what we say at this stage is payback, so how long is it going to take to pay it back for us?
Yeah, so this will typically replace between 50 and 120-watt metal halide type lamps.
Right, okay.
And, you know, you'd expect energy terms, they're saying a payback of just a little over a year, about 1.25 years to get your energy payback.
And what with a 10-hour running per day sort of thing?
Yes.
Okay, that makes sense as well. I know, obviously with that in mind, surge protection's really popular now. Have they built any surge into the actual device itself?
Yeah, so that's obviously a thing. Street lighting, again, depends where you are in the world. Obviously, the further south you get, the more likelihood of lightning strikes causing a problem. So this has 4kV fault protection built in.
That's good.
So that's a great feature, especially for outdoor lighting, and you may not be aware of that when you're sourcing replacement lamps. It lasts 50,000 hours to L70.
Oh, right, and I know what L70 is because I've seen the video Joe produced on it, and I'd like you to think we're going to leave that in the link in the description, yeah, so you can understand what that really means. It means it's 70% of its brightness after 50,000 hours, did you say?
Yeah,
that's pretty good. Yeah, I've watched the video. So when I was looking through the sheets on it and looking at the product itself, it said it's IP rating, and I just need a little bit of explanation there from the point of view. There's two IP ratings to it, isn't there?
Yeah, there is. So the front part up to here is IP rated IP65.
Right, okay.
Now that's important. You think some of these older heritage fittings, the lamp may have been exposed.
Ah, right, yeah.
And obviously you put a retrofit lamp in, you don't want flies getting in there. It may be subjected to obviously severe weather. So that's the front bit, IP65.
Right.
Obviously at the back, we have an electrical connection. That's IP20. Obviously from that point on, it depends upon the lamp holder you're putting it into.
And we've got a lamp holder here, so we can liven it up, and it's an E27 screw, is it?
Yes, it is, yes.
Okay, so if you wanna just pull off the cap then, and we'll bring this round, and we'll liven this one up. Yep, there we go, we're on.
So you know, it's instant light, so obviously that's the major advantage over the traditional lamps. You'd have a sort of warm-up period, so this doesn't suffer from that. Obviously there's a lot of light coming out of here, there's 4,000 lumens. So the big difference here between when you look at a corn lamp, corn lamps tend to be sort of cylindrical and the light comes out in a cylindrical pattern. With this Gen 4 product, you've got a more even distribution of light and more light going underneath the lamp, which is important if it was a sort of a vertical lamp in an existing fixture.
And I think you can see that there, can't you? So we're not actually getting loads of light back here where we don't need it. Obviously the light is being thrown down onto the surface.
Yeah. So that's, you know, the fact that it's more lamp-shaped is what you're replacing would work with, say, if there's an existing reflector in the system. Yeah, it's going to give you a very similar light distribution. Colour temperature-wise, we've got 4,000 Kelvin here. Also comes in at 2,700 Kelvin. Obviously, a lot of, if we're thinking historic, sometimes that warmer white is preferred.
It 100% is, yeah, and we've seen that, and when we're walking about, again, a clever solution, isn't it, to a problem that's out there that maybe as electricians we're not really thinking about. We're all thinking about take out and replace, but obviously this lamp allows us to leave in that heritage fitting and get some great light out of it and in the right areas.
And then possible last thing, obviously we're thinking about temperature rating, so this will go from minus 20 to plus 60.
Right, okay.
So, you know, minus 20, yeah, in the north of Europe all the way down to the plus 60, possibly in the south, we might be getting back to being able to travel again, so I'll gladly take that along with me.
If you're taking it on holiday, is there any issues with weight with this kind of lamp, Gordon?
Well, not with the lamp there isn't, Gary, but if you carry on eating those cakes, there will be soon. This one, obviously, yeah, weight can play a factor in choosing a retrofit lamp, because what you don't want to do is stress the lamp holder itself, but thankfully this is only 380 grams, so shouldn't cause any problems there.
So as always, we're interested in your feedback. Have you fitted any of these Osram HQL LED Pro Generation 4 lamps by Ledvance? Have you got any top tips for the community about fitting retrofit lamps? We'd love those down there in the comments. And if you see someone in there struggling, could you help us by answering their questions if you know the answer? And we'll try and get back to as many of those comments as we can.